What's your viewpoint? What are you doing in order to focus on the ecosystem, in order to work with your client to understand the risk? Because you are part of a critical infrastructure. So you are in one of the most sensitive spots where this type of risk can create havoc for everyone. So how are you working with your clients?
Yes, we of course need first of all to reinforce our capability to face security, also due to the new strategic footprint of our company. That means we adopt and we manage a global security model that try to address security in two main domains. The corporate domain, where the first goal is to protect our IP, that is the IT domain. And if I give you some key figures, we need to work to connect in 100 sites, 4,000 working station internal and plus 1,000 external of our partner. We run more than 2,250 application platforms. We produce more than 1.5 million technical documents per year. So these support the kind of complexity and the issue we need to manage internally, but we adopt, of course, the security model based on four key capabilities. That means governance, that is detection, that is response recovery, and of course, prevention. But on the other side, the industrial side, we need to guarantee the operating continuity, as you underlined correctly, being part of an ecosystem where the energy value chain is part from power generation, but we have distribution, transmission, distribution, and more digitization is going to impact in the business through the smart grid and of course the services towards the end consumer. So we worked here on compliance, first of all, so compliance. We are part of the National Observatory for Cybersecurity of electric critical infrastructure promoted by University of Genoa, and being part of the key players, the manager of critical infrastructure, the industry, and some technical partners like Leonardo, that try to work together in order to find out the new guidelines in terms of the regulation and standards we need to apply. But on the other side, we need to apply the security by design approach. We need to pass from a way in which power generation through the segregation of the different components of the plants guarantee security. Now it's a completely different world. We need to work from the beginning with the final customer and all the other stakeholders in order to find out a way to protect all our OT. We are looking for a solution that will be in our portfolio of service, because we need to guarantee resiliency in a dynamic way. And we need to apply this not only to the engineering, construction, and commissioning of new plants, but also to retrofit the current plants, power plants, and our technology. So the big effort going in this direction, and we need to work in this ecosystem, especially to try to address, as I told before, our supply chain. And because our supply chain, when we realize a new power plant, we have more than 1,000 components, more than 350 suppliers. All these suppliers should be aligned from the beginning. And so this is a big effort we need to put together, because otherwise the capability to generate benefits from digitization to manage the risk coming to cyber will be weaker. We need to operate as a system.
That's a huge number of interactions, but it is even larger if you consider all the pieces that these actors are bringing in, because in fact everybody brings something to a very huge plant or a very huge system, and we have the issue of understanding the security of all pieces, as we're saying, because the weakest link is the one that is going to make you fail. So from the viewpoint of your expertise in dealing with endpoints and so which enormous number of devices, What's the way to try and guarantee this? How can you stay ahead of the proliferation of devices? How much do you resort to artificial intelligence, to machine learning techniques, versus design, security by design in the overall aspect?
I think there's lots of different industries that face similar problems. We're all trying to connect more devices, we're all trying to collect data, but it's always a case of technologies available or perceived to be available to solve some of these problems. Really what we need to look at is what the business problems are and look at the full supply chain, because security, as we all know, is as good as your weakest link. So we need to look at all of those people across that supply chain